Hello, Virgo. Thank you very much for tuning into this week's read. For the main part of the read, I'm using Tarot Illuminati by Eric C. Dunn, Supportive Oracle Cards, Chakra Wisdom Oracle Cards by Tori Hartman, illustrated by Gretchen. And there's Gretchen's last name. That way, if you'd like to find those creators, that's how you do it. All right, I already shuffled. Virgo. Why do we have this little interesting little spot here? We'll get into that in a minute. Okay. The cat is all in a good mood, so. He's throwing my sneakers around, so if you hear him, that's what he's doing. He's throwing my sneakers around. Because that's what he does when he's in a good mood. Coming into this, Virgo, you're holding back starting right off, which is good. You're looking at a situation you got to handle. So I don't know if it's really elective or just something that you're accepting, like, I need to do something with that. And you're figuring out what you need to do with it, but you're holding it to yourself. This is something you're probably not communicating with anybody. Some of you, maybe to some very trusted people, maybe. But a lot of you, I feel like you're just keeping it, you know, playing it close to your chest, kind of like, I have to deal with that. What do I want to do with that? That's how it starts off. The reason this is currently there's a lot going on with the situation. There's a lot to be handled. It seems to be the Five of Swords is the fruitless wind, where things are technically going well, but when you're looking at it, you're like, well, I guess they're going well, but they're really not going that good. Like, it's working, and you're kind of questioning that. It's kind of like people getting to school on time, but the person taking them there is a little bit they're just kind of like, it's like that cranky old man taking them to school. You're just kind of like, I don't know if they should be. I mean, they've made it every day so far, but I don't really know if I like that influence around my kids, but it's technically working. It's one of those energies, kind of like it's technically working right now. Don't know if I really like it, but it's technically making it. And I feel like it's one of those situations, kind of like, no, I don't know if I really like how this is playing. I mean, it's making the grade, I guess, for now, but it's kind of like just barely passing. This is something you're not expecting, because you're going to come forward and there's going to be a change with this situation. I feel like when you first come towards it, you're not, because this card is face down, you're not expecting a fight, but you're ending up in a fight. Five of Wands is telling me you're arguing with somebody. Because the situation has to change, and I almost feel like you've already decided the situation does need to change, and you know it does. Somebody else is saying, I don't think it does, and you're like, well, it is. Well, it is changing. I've had it. I'm not doing this anymore. I don't like how it is. I don't feel like it's okay. So you're bringing forth this air of, like, we're going to change this. I feel at first people are like, no, I don't think we need to. I think things are fine the way they are. They're comfortable the way they are. And you're like, no, they're not. I don't like them. I don't like how they're going. We're going to change them. Which seems good. I don't see any problems with it, but I'm getting, like, when you push the issue, literally when you push it, then you have possibilities coming in. Not until you push it, though. You're going to have to push it, is what I'm getting. When that happens, you get things turning. A lot happens. You push it. Possibilities come in. Other people seem to realize, like, all right, well, then I guess we're changing it then. There's energy around you that wants to make you happy, is what I'm getting, because they realize you're really not happy with the situation. It's no longer acceptable. It's going to change. You've made up your mind. It will change. Possibilities are being thought out. More good things around you are coming in. Like, something is coming towards you, supporting your change, something very positive. When you see this possibility, like, the wheel is turning, you're looking at possibilities anyway, but this wheel of, like, something really good is coming towards you that we weren't expecting, kind of like say this old man was taking them to school, and he was a little bit crotchety, and you're just like, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. So maybe your sister or another relative or a friend that you actually like, somebody who has kids that you know treats kids well, is like, oh, well, I just changed my hours. I could do that. I mean, I'm going that way anyway. I have no problem taking them. I can do that for you. Like, that possibility comes in. Something like some good possibility comes toward you. Kind of like, oh, but isn't that like a you know, it's like a town out of your way. Like, oh, it's not a problem. I don't care. They're kids. It's fine. I could drop them off. I have no problem. Like, somebody's like, no, I can do it. Excuse me. But this is somebody who you're like, yeah, they have kids. I like the way they treat kids. I like that whole energy. I'm good with that. Actually, I would really prefer this person do that. I don't think I'd worry about my kids if that was who was doing this. Discovery with impatience. I feel like you work something out fairly quickly. Fairly quickly. Especially with impatience here. But like once you discover this possibility, you're like, yeah, okay, let's do it. As soon as you're ready to do that, let's do it. The sooner the better. You might even make temporary provisions while things change over because you don't want the old guy doing it. I don't know why we're having this old guy moment, but I'm especially since one day I'll be that old guy, so I don't know. But I'm having one of those moments. So from the time where you've decided that's not going to happen to the time where the new one starts, you might be doing something different, something temporary in the interim. There might be something going on there. But I'm getting a whole new situation comes in with the death card. A whole new way of doing things. Now, at this part of the reading, I feel like a new process has started. That part has been solved. But this other person who is helping you, which I keep referring to as the old man. I don't know why, but there you go. That seems to be what the rest of this is about, is solving that situation. Because I feel like at first, you're not really wanting to talk about it. You're just kind of like, I'll just let it go. Things have changed. Life is busy. And I feel like the other side, whoever this person is kind of trying to let it go at the same time too. But even though they're trying to kind of let it go, they have vanity kind of pushing them up at the same time. Somebody's a little bit upset with how things change. They don't understand. They feel like, I was doing you a favor, and then you treated me like that. There's one of those things going on. So how it changed and how everything turned around, I feel like there needs to be a talk just about, you know, you might have to just wrap it up. However it turned around, I don't know, there's like a wrapping up of the energy here. Because if it's a loose end, it's a problem. Like, if that doesn't get addressed, it's going to fester. And it's kind of like when you have something in the basement, maybe the cat, because I have a cat, you know, caught some animal, little animal, and left it behind something and you don't know it. And it festers there, and then all of a sudden you're like, it smells disgusting down here. Why does it smell so bad down here? Then you find that, and then you got to clean it up, and you got to do, and there's other nastiness that you have to clean up. Like, the longer it goes, the bigger of a mess it is. That's what I'm trying to say. So, and it could breed other problems, so you want to deal with it as soon as you know it's there, right? The longer it goes, like, if you use that analogy, it's not just it smells, it draws other things, so you want to get rid of it as soon as you know about it. You want to clean it up as soon as you know about it. The longer it's there, the worse it gets. I feel like you have to kind of deal with it. I feel like you're going to... The reason gossip is here in this situation is like you're going to hear through the grapevine that this person's a little bit miffed, a little bit upset, a little bit nose out of joint, whatever. When you start hearing that with the gossip, they're saying, come in and just deal with the situation. Just talk it out, whatever you need to do. Like, you know, squelch that energy. It's going to get worse the longer it goes. And I'm getting whatever it is, at some point you will have to deal with it. There's no getting away from it. Just resolving the energy. I don't know exactly what that means. Because I do feel forgiveness here. Kind of like, it's almost like if I was looking at this the way I'm feeling about this, kind of like, all right, thank you for doing what you did. You were helpful then. I just didn't like some of the, you know, I just didn't think that was working out in certain ways. I mean, like the stories kids were telling me, I didn't like it. So I changed it. I am thankful for what you did do, but yeah, no, this was, I don't know how far you want to get into it, but basically just saying, you know, thank you for helping me when you did help me, but from now on I won't need that. I understand you went out of your way to help me and I appreciate it. How much of the addressing of the why you had to change it, I don't know, that's up to you, obviously. Because I feel like you're going to have to. Just for some point, because in the environment, there's the Ten of Swords, which is devastation with destiny. Whatever the reason was, you had to change what it was. And I know it's not, it's different scenarios based on what you're dealing with. Somebody's going to be upset, but I feel like you had to do what you had to do, and you really felt it was the correct thing to do. Somebody's going to be very upset. Destiny's with that, kind of like they needed to hear this. That's how you felt. I don't feel like, well, however you feel, you definitely feel vindicated. I'm not feeling there's anything wrong with how you felt. As long as it's addressed. Because I feel like you're just telling this person, like, here's the reasons. I feel like you have to tell that person with the hair effect, like, here are the reasons. This is why I changed it. I'm thankful. Thank you for helping me while you did. I understand you went out of your way. But this is why I had to change it. I mean, even though I'm very thankful, you know, I can't send my kids to school dealing with that type of situation or hearing that type of language or hearing those type of stories. So for what it was, thank you. But, I mean, that's the truth on why I had to change it, whatever it was. There's tension between this person and you. I get that going further from here. Whatever the situation is, obviously, again, it's whatever scenario you're connecting it with. So there's tension with the grief. Completion where this, once you talk to this person and let them know, hey, thank you, but this is why, I'm getting like they're going to back off and they won't be a problem. You're kind of squelching that energy. They don't seem to be too happy, but they don't seem to be bothering you at the same time. And then your card here is perception, kind of like they're saying, realize that you had to do what you had to do. And once you went through and you talked it out and you dealt with it or addressed the situation, I feel like you put an end to it. You put a cap on it. You put a lid on it. You know, you tied it up. It's done. Don't let this other person's energy bother you, is what I'm getting. Especially after you go to the person and you explain how you felt, then let that be the end. Don't worry about it for me on that point, because you did what you had to do. Like, there's nothing to feel bad about, is what I'm getting. It's got to be addressed, though. I'm not sure what happens if you don't address it, though, other than, like, it becomes a bigger problem. It starts to breed out to other situations. But if you address it, it puts a lid on it, ties it up, done. Especially because, I don't know, other people aren't upset. Other people seem to understand, like, you talk to that person and you thank them. Thank you for what you did, but this is why I had to change it. I understand you did help, and thank you for helping, but this is why I had to change it. Nothing to feel bad about. I don't feel like there's anything to feel bad about. All right, I'm going to shut this down here. I hope that helps. Thank you for watching. If you'd like a direct reading from me, shoot me an email, james4astral@gmail.com. That's james4astral@gmail.com. Thank you.